Hey guys, this is SMG here, and I'm going to be playing Asian Mythology today. Well, not exactly playing. I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. Well, actually a lot different. I'm going to be showing you guys how to use the editor. So, this is going to be an editor tutorial, I guess. This is just going to be for beginners, and then I'll start working the way up. Alright. So, I'm going to go through most of these and explain what they do. Alright, so I'll start here. This is brush settings. So yeah, you don't need that yet. Hold on. Alright, so this is to raise or lower the ground. So you left-click to raise it, right-click to lower. You can also choose the speed so it's slower or faster. Alright, so all this stuff is pretty much is just terrain. This is also terrain and water and forest. So let's get started with units. Alright, so you click here to place units. And there are multiple options for the different kinds. Buildings, units, nature, test, current, and I'll be showing you how to use most of these. Alright, so first you just want to click on it, and then you can left click and then left click to place it where you want to. I mean, it's pretty obvious that, but I'm not going to be making a really clear map right now. I'm just going to show you guys. Alright, so you click here to change the team of what you want to place. Alright, see now how it's red now? It's on team 2. So let's say if you want to make these guys fight hoblets, you can put a whole army of hoblets. Alright, so an easy way of getting a lot, you go to edit, unit copy, edit, unit paste. This can be glitchy sometimes. Like
Vulome.
Like right now, it doesn't want to work. Alright. Attempt 2. Unit copy. Unit paste. There we go. Alright, sometimes they'll be standing backwards like that. Oh, never mind. They'll be standing the same way as you had them. Let's say you want to make a whole big army. Very fast. It's a lot faster than all the way. But you can't place them inside each other. Alright, so if you wanted to test what you made so far, you go to Scenario, and then Play Test Scenario. It's right here. And then you pick what team you want to play test it. So I'll be play testing at Team 1. And then when you quit out of this, it'll just go all back to where it was. This can be laggy if you have a lot of things on the screen. Lightning bolt. And you start off with the main god powers that your god does that you choose. And I'll get to that in just a minute. As you can see, hoplites are good at killing heroes, so the heroes weren't going to win this fight at all. Alright, so let's go back. You just quit to go back to where you were. Well, you can also make them walk while they're in this mode too. But if you want to make the opposite team walk, see, I'm right clicking right now and it doesn't work. You gotta go to place object and change it back to player 2. Also, if you can either center click or the scroll button, whatever it's called, on here, or you can press escape. Sometimes it glitches up when you center click and this won't go away. Here, let me try getting that. There we go. See, I'm center clicking right now, it won't go away. And if I press escape, it still won't go away. So how you fix that, you just click right here again and then you press escape. I had a lot of trouble with that, and I always had to save and quit to restart it because I didn't know how to fix it. Alright, so right here, this is to delete objects and units. and it's a quick way, or you can just click on them and press delete, and they go away. Or highlight them, delete. Okay. So say you don't want them to get out of this area, you would make mountains like this. Wow, it lags when I make mountains. Or hills, whatever you want to call them. Anyways, what that's doing is they can't walk up the cliff side. Well, that's what it's called. The cliff is... You go to paint. Hold on. I'll show you guys some more detail. Go to free paint. And if you right-click on something you want to put down, that's the easy way of getting it. Like, if you right-click on the grass, you can just cover that back up. Right-click right there. Right there. And I believe if it's under cliff. Yeah. See, other cliffs look different, but they work in the same way. So, basically, they can't walk on cliff. Even if it's flat on the ground, they can't walk on it. So if they try to escape, there's no escaping, from what I can see. And different paint will do different stuff. So like, I think this one, it's just more square than others, I guess. There are some that won't let you build on it. Or place objects, which is can get really annoying, especially when you don't know it at first, and then you put it all around your map, and then you have to fix it. It happens a lot to me. So, anyways, if you want to place trees, you just go to forest, and these are the different kind of trees you have to place. There's also a way to place trees individually, and that would be in units under nature. Okay, see the tundra right there? So if I scroll all the way back to the top and I just want to get to it really fast, you can just press T and it'll take you down to the T. Or I can press M and it'll take me back up to the M's. So I'm going to choose mixed oak forest. I'll show you guys the different types. So this is mixed. This is oak forest. Hades Forest, Marsh, Mixed Palm Forest, Mixed Pine Forest, Oak Forest, Palm Forest, Pine Forest, Savannah Forest, Snow Pine Forest, Tundra Forest. And that is all. As you can see, there's quite a bit of different forests you can choose from. My favorite, though, would have to be the mixed oak forest, just because it's the most realistic. Or, for where I am. Alright. So, after you put these down, villagers can chop them down. You don't really have to do anything special to set that up. And to place water, you click right here where it says paint water. You click on which kind of water you want. I'm not going to go all through the water. It's going to take long. But Greek River is my favorite. It really depends on the map I'm making. But as you can see, the water will push the land up. So it doesn't look natural. So what you can do to fix that is flatten the land out. I'm gonna show you guys the easy. Oh, before I do that, these two buttons up here. I don't know if you know this or not, but this is the undo, and it will go back as many steps as you like it to go. Except if you save it and come back, then you can't press the undo button anymore. All right. So say if you wanna flatten your land out a very easy way. Okay, you go to world, you go to elevation, and you move it down all the way. It's probably easy way. Yeah, this. Alright. So now the whole map is flat. And now if you want to place water on this, you're not going to be able to at this low, so probably move it up a little. Yep, that's probably good. Alright, now you can see the cliffs are flat, but they still can't walk over it. Alright. So, now the water should look more natural. And then you can make it... You can make it look better with, you click on this, edit water, you click on the water, click beautify, it'll add some trees and rocks around it to look more natural. Also, with like a ocean water, it'll add waves to it. And if you're wondering how to add fish, you go to units. Press F to get down to the F class. And... Oh, no, sorry guys, it's in nature. Press F again. And did they change the location since the last game? I think they might have. Oh, that's because they're not called fish, my bad. It's called perch and such. My bad, guys. Alright, so you press P to get down to perch. And then you just click to place it. Now, I'm going to teach you guys something pretty cool. If you place them all in one spot, don't move them out at all, and place a whole bunch. And even though this might not be beneficial to whatever kind of map you're making, but it does look pretty cool when you save it. I play online a lot, so that's why I have so many different... download their files. And I'm going to name this one Fishy 3000. And I'm just going to put a 1 right here because this goes in alphabetical order. And 1's in the front for some reason. Alright. Saved it. Come back in. You don't need to do this, guys. It will automatically do it even if you don't save all and don't come back in. So now the fish will be going in like that, and it looks pretty awesome. Alright, so that's just something cool I thought I'd show you guys. Also, if you want to make your mountains look more natural, you just click on whatever mountain you want. The more you click it, the higher it go. Right clicking it will make it go down more, so you can actually have a cliff, except the map's not that deep, so you can't make it go that deep. And cliffs are one of the best tools for map making, because that's like setting the boundaries to where you can and can't go. Even though flying units can go over cliffs, there's no way of stopping those, I don't think. And say you don't like this grass right here, you just click free paint, right click, and just get rid of the grass. And if there's too much mountain, just get rid of some of that. Alright. Say you don't like how sharp the mountains look. I know that's a weird use, or rough, I mean. Click this right here, the smooth. And what you do is you left click, you hold it down, and it will smooth out the terrain for you. This will work even when in water. Alright guys, I forgot to show you one thing with Beautify. The more you click it, the more stuff will come up. And eventually it'll just look like a tree surrounding a lake. Which that's what it is. And again, if you want to delete something, you highlight it, press delete. Easy as that. Alright. So say if you want a pathway leading out, we'll delete these guys. Alright, so the starting of the base, you always want to put down a town center. To get to a town center, you press T, and it's right here. And now, team 1 will be the player that has the file. And you want to put it down where you want to start it, pretty much. Okay. So, if you would want to create a challenge for somebody, this is what I used to do when I was little, playing the original Age of Mythology. I'd just make a long pathway like this. And like this. And just add a whole bunch of units in there. I usually start from easiest to hardest. Like I'll put like 3 titans back here, and right here I would put like something weaker, the weakest thing. But since I've gotten better, I know how to. I'm not really sure how it works, but I know that if you put another town center down, you don't even have to put the AI in. You could just go to, I'll show you guys after, but you could go to multiplayer. Well, hold on. Let me see if it still works on this Age of Mythology. Okay, place a second town center down. Press save. Return to main menu. Oh, it does still have land. Okay. So, you go to land. Okay. Hold on, guys. Sorry. So, you're here, and you just type in whatever you want your nickname to be. It doesn't matter. I think it has to be within 18 letters. So I'm just going to type in SMG. So now you click host. This is just the easy way without having to insert your own AI. And then remember to set the difficulty before you go to scenario. So, say I want it on Titan. And then you go to scenario. I named it Fishy 3000. One Fishy 3000. And as you can see now, I cannot change the difficulty. And there are 9 other, or 8 other players here. And you can get people in the same house as you to join, or you can play this game online. You can make games for people online so you can all enjoy it, or you just mess around with it. I got really far. Excuse me. I got really far into making games online, like into a level. I put a lot of work into it, and it ended up not working, and I stopped playing Ninja Mythology for like a year. It really got me annoyed. But, yeah. Right. So, for some reason, my screen isn't full. I hope it doesn't affect you. But I'm still gonna continue doing this. Alright, so let's go back. It'll put your most recent things right here. Just in case you want to load it. Okay, this is gonna get annoying to me. I can't do this. Don't you just hate Windows Firewall? I mean, I was almost done with this video. And it had to interrupt me. Sorry guys for the interruption, but I don't have any video editing software, so you're gonna have to watch. Let's go to options. Should have a full screen option right here. Somewhere. Okay, let's go back. And okay. Alright, I fixed it. Alright, thanks guys for sticking with me. It's a little bug and I didn't feel like doing that. Alright, so let's just start here with fresh new. And let's pick a town center for each of us that are gonna play. So this is all. Go to buildings. Well, I mean, you could go to all and find town center, but it's easier just to go to buildings. And it's right here. So you click one down for yourself. One down for an AI or a friend. And if you want another friend or a different AI to play, one right here. And you can keep on doing this for like 18 people, is it? 11. 12 people maximum. But the more people that you add in, keep in mind that it's going to be more laggy. Well, unless you have a top-graded computer, and it's not going to lag at all, but... now, say you want to create some barriers, so you can't just go straight to them. You have to put some detail into the map. Okay, so I'm going to put a mountain right here, so these guys can't pass. One right here. Keep in mind, if I was I was making a map for real, like a good map, I would be putting much more detail into it than this. And making sure everybody has even stuff. Alright. Oops. Always is that undo, boys and girls. Alright, so see, everybody has to meet up in the middle to get to the other side, which this is intentional by me, but you could also make other ways. And you can also make the map bigger, but I'm going to keep it the size, but I'll show you how to do that. You click map size, and there's a maximum of like, I think it's like 400 or something, maybe 600, I don't know. So you would just click put 100 in each side. And that will make your map bigger, period. Alright, so I'm not going to do that though, because I don't really need my map to be bigger. So, if you want to move a unit, you can, or a building, you can click right here, click that building, and then you can move it around. And then you can just like it. But with buildings, it'll get them stuck in the ground sometimes. It won't have any effect on them. It'll just make it look dumb. So you'll have to flatten the ground underneath them. Alright, so to get out of this, you just center click. Sometimes that doesn't work like it just did. So you have to go back into it and press escape. Alright, an easier way of doing this without having to go in that, you hold the center click button down and you just move it. But with this, you can't spin it around. With this, you can. By scrolling. All right. So for AI players, they even if they have max resources, they need trees or else they don't function right for some reason. They need trees. They need food, animals, and they need gold. No matter how much supplies You give them from the beginning. And to change their supplies, you go to scenario, player data, and this gives all the supplies for every player. Let me close this real quick. If you only want four players to be at this map at a time, you go to scenario. Where did it go? Scenario data, there it is. And then you would click four people, cause, or AI, doesn't matter, because that's how many are going to be playing the map at the same time. And you just click OK, and you'd be good. Okay. Now, say you want to make the terrain even without using the smooth tool. Now, to make flat terrain, you just left click and drag with this tool right here. This will also change the color of the whatever you use it on. See, it doesn't work on grass, but it will work here because it's a different. There, see? It works. Alright, to undo, you just click right here and everything will be fixed. So you don't really have to worry about mistakes in this one. Unless you accidentally save it and quit after you already done something that messed the whole level up. Which I have not done before, but it could happen. Alright, so this is the pathway, nothing special. I usually use it to point out special hidden things, but I'll just use it to show the way to each town center. Also, you can turn on allies. What you have to do is just get other people to team up with you. It's pretty simple, but I'll go over it anyway. I mean, anybody that plays Ancient Mythology already knows about it, but there's people that probably don't, so I'll go over it. Alright, so that. And like that. Make it a big circle in the middle. Okay. And I kind of want to flatten out this land right here. These are the different options, so if you want to be large, so you can flat out better. Because that kind of looked dumb. Right there. You smooth it all out. By the way, I'm smoothing it by left clicking. If you guys didn't know. Most of the stuff in here is by left clicking. There are shortcuts to things, but it's easier just learning the basics first. Alright, so you need gold now if you want to play with AIs. Now, you don't need this if you're going to play with other players and you turn up the money really high. Like, say I added like a bunch of food, you wouldn't need it because you have enough to last forever. But no matter what, the AIs are going to need gold, wood, and food. Just to begin with, at least food, though. And they'll start farming and making markets. Or else they don't operate right, and I don't know why this is. Alright, so I'm going to give everybody 600 to begin with, just so we can get a little faster start. Just 600 food, actually. And then I didn't know that you could get to that from here. Alright, so close, and it will save. That was the wrong one, you dumb. Player data, and it's still here. Pop is the population, if you guys didn't know. The maximum is 300. I normally like to set it to 150, so you can actually make it all the way to 300. And keep in mind, you want to keep the population low if you have a lot of people playing. Alright, so favor, or I sometimes call it worship. I don't know why. Probably it's mostly the same thing, but it's basically what your villagers do when they're at the temple praying, or with the Egyptians, it's the statues. With Norse, it's from fighting, and I have no idea what the Lantians are. I've been trying to figure that out for a long time. If you guys know, leave a comment to tell me, even though this is a tutorial. So I wanted to start with 100 population each time from the beginning. Now this player is going to be you, but you can change your god when you go into the LAN party. And also, if you have another person playing with you, he can change his god. But you cannot change your color in the LAN party, but you can change your color here. But it's just for looks. There's no point in changing your color. But if you want to test it with these gods, then you can always switch them. And it'll switch right away. So I'll go back over here. And as you can see, it's Isis or Ra now. And I'll change it to Hades. And Kronos. Okay. You guys get the idea. Alright, so now you're making the AI's base. It should look like this. And now you would want to add golden. There's gold large, gold medium, and gold tiny. The only difference from them are the amount of gold it holds. The gold large holds the most gold, obviously, and the gold small or tiny holds the most, or the least. And you just click where you want to place them. And you don't want to make it too close to their base either, because the AIs in this game can be really buggy sometimes. And sometimes if they get stuck, they won't attack at all, and it'll get boring. So add a couple gold mines all over the place. Yeah, I'll just do every single base. It's not that far. So I'll put four gold mines on each base. And I'll put some in the middle for a prize. For whoever's in the middle. Okay, so I put a whole bunch down in the middle, and say I want to move them, I can do it like this. Well, I probably should flatten out the ground because it looks really stupid. All right, there we go. Alright, so I want to move them now, so I can move them all to the same spot. They'll still mine it, and it glows really bright. And so what that'll do, that'll save on space, but there's still a lot of gold there. And I forgot to put gold on the bottom. Alright, you guys want to make it even as you can for each player, so don't give yourself 1,000 resources when the other person starts off with zero. Unless you're planning on having an attack defender game or something like that. Alright. As you guys can see, they have even resources. And say if you ran out of resources, then you had to build a market, which I'm sure you guys know. Yeah, they would have to get camels and get gold and trade it for wood or whatever resource they needed. Alright, say it. These are hacks. They're just for looks. Let me put it to guy just in case it decides to be buggy. And change it to my team sometimes. It does that. And so, if you put one down, it'll just roam the map by itself. Just for looks. They cannot be killed unless it's tight. Actually, they can be, but it's like it had to be an accident. Like a titan was attacking this or something and it flew over. He did this smash and he would die. That is the only way. Or tornadoes too, actually. And god powers like that. Okay. Now the next thing you're going to want to do is add food in. Or berry bushes or animals. So I'm going to add some deer. This is going to look pretty much the same for each of them, just spread out in different areas. And deer will not attack. However, elephants, if you put elephants down, they will attack. Rhinoceros attack, crocodiles attack, hyenas attack, wolves attack, bears attack, you get the idea. Alright, so now you want to put some animals that they'll start off with. I would say at least four. Goats or pigs, cows. Cows give you more meat than the goats or pigs. And it'll automatically go to their team if it's near them. I'll put four on this guy. Doesn't have to be all straight, doesn't matter. And also another good one to start off with is chickens, probably like six. Just because if you run out of food, it really sucks because you can't, there's no way of getting food. Now if you want to put some more randomly around the map so they can bring it back to their town center, that would be good. Doesn't really have to be even. I just make sure there's enough for everybody. Also, relics, they will spawn with a random effect. Some of them will grant you golden lions, some of them will give you monkeys, some of them will increase your hit points. They're all random. I don't think I've seen all of them yet, but I like to put them in spots that you don't check very often. So like, someone's not going to check this corner. But keep in mind that you're going to have to put, you have to make it fair for them, so put one right here. Right here. Right here. And I'll put one over here. You don't need relics, but I like to put them in just because. Also put, a cool idea of doing is putting a relic in the gold so they have to mine all the gold to get to the relic. You can't see the relic from here, as you can see. You can still move it around. See? Just move it right into the gold. And I don't think they can pick it up. You can also do the same thing with forest. Just put the relic in the forest and make them have to dig the forest. Or cut the forest, not dig it, you derp. Alright, so this water just... this water. This map doesn't really need water. It is all grass, mountains. There's already a lot of... there's not enough room for water. I mean, you could still do it, just make a little pond, but it'd be pointless. You can also make this look better by placing grass and stuff. Not like this kind of grass that you're seeing here, but you go to, I'm not sure what grass is. I think it might be under this G. It's probably under nature. Right here. So you can put grass down like this, and it makes it look better. I'll make this a full map for you guys. You can actually see how I'll make a good map. I probably would have put more detail into the walkway, though, that just myself. I especially like showing maps off to my friends when they get here, and I like to play my maps online. So if you guys would want me to put my maps online so you guys can download them off the Age of Mythology online, I'll be there, but I'll just wait for you guys to join so you can download. I'll make it the 12 player, and then you can download it and leave. If you guys would want. Remember, you don't need grass either. It just makes it look better, just for looks. And also, there's Gaia Forest. You're not able to do that in regular forest. And this is how you put individual trees down. You go to a tree, and this is tree savanna, tree oak burning. So this will be on fire. That one's not on fire, but that one's on fire. And I am not sure if you can chop those down or not. I don't know, under bushes. Apparently nothing. Alright, so same thing with Vulture with the other thing, with the other thing. If you put one down, it'll just start roaming the map. You also want to make sure you're in Gaia when you're placing deer, because you can have deer on your team. By that, I mean like team 1, team 2, team 3, or team 4. If you're on Gaia, though, it will be just, I guess you would call it Gaia. And anybody can kill it. And they don't fight back unless they're bears. And you guys get the idea. Alright, so in this is mostly like fountains, boulder walls, things that you would find in the campaign. You can also make your place look pretty cool. They have the guardian. This guy's pretty tough. Hold on. Let me find the real one. You know that he's the one that he moved, because he moves a little bit. Like he's breathing. His sword moves. This one's the even bigger one. There's a lot of different ones. This one's. This one's the one that doesn't move, obviously, because you can't see his sword moving. This one will not move. When I was little, I didn't understand this. I'm like, why is it not moving, Daddy? Make it move for me. That sounded weird. But, yeah. And as you can see, this is also from the campaign. I've seen people make cool maps out of these. Alright, so I'm going to show you how to make stuff larger and how to shrink stuff. Alright, so let me get a good unit for the job. I'll use a tower. Or actually, sentry tower, they're called. Where is it? Am I blind? Yes. You guys are probably yelling at me. It's right there! That's right on your face! Alright, so this is team 1, so. Alright, this is just for looks again. Alright, so you would press K to make it larger, and Shift K to make it smaller. And you can go as big or as large or as small that you want to make it. It's a cute detailed baby tower. And it has no effect on anything else except for how large or how small it is. It'll still do the same attack and everything. So if you want to make a really large chicken, you know what to do. Press K. Hold K, actually. And then if you want to make a really, really small chicken, you would press and hold Shift K. And then eventually you can make it small enough where you can't see it, which would not be a good idea. Okay, this chicken's gonna be a little bit above average of size. Alright, so if you wanted to play the map right now, you would be able to, but I'm gonna go a little bit further into it. And I'm going to go into what was I gonna go into? I just had a brain fart, guys. Alright, so I'm gonna show you a little bit more of the campaign stuff and stuff like that. Alright, so these are crates. All these things are pretty much for looks. Those are for, like, if you want to make a movie, which I'm not sure how to do. This is Earth, obviously. I mean, you could put it on the map, like, if you're battling. But it's kind of pointless. Firewood. If you want to make something look like it's on fire, don't use fire. Use fire huge. Or no, wait. I know one of the fires are dumb, and they're not actually a fire. Yeah, that's not a fire. That is definitely not a fire. The first fire is not a fire, guys. This is the actual fire. There's a big difference. And I'll press undo just onto it. Alright, so the fire sizes are going to be different every time. So it kind of stinks, but you kind of have to just grow with it if it's not the size that you wanted. Alright, so fire huge is obviously what it says, fire huge. And it makes sound. Fire Hades. I don't know the difference. A lot of this stuff and embellishments, I don't know what they do. I know what flag does. It just initiates your color. You can also switch it to team 2. And this will switch depending on what god you are. Team 3. This is Egyptian, I think. And team 4, which I think is Atlantean. And then this one is Norse. No, this one's Egyptian. I'm really bad at guessing flags. This one is Norse, and this one's Atlantean. And this one's obviously Greek. Alright, you don't need this flag for anything. Like I said, it's just for looks. Fence iron you can use, and pretty much just for looks. Alright, so I think that's the last thing I want to show you. If you want to place a wall really easy, you go to objects, place wall, and whatever team that you have selected at the time, it will make the wall for it. And you click one spot, just like you were making it in a match, and then you click right here, and then it'll place a wall for you. And if you want to place another, but a different team, team 1, and go to objects, place wall. There you go. And if you want to make one for all of them, you just go through this again. Place wall. There you go. One more. Objects. Place wall. Alright, see, if you build something over your flag, it'll just disappear. Which is a good thing. Alright, so now say you want a gate, you just click right here. You have to be on that side, that team now. Then you have to, you click convert to gate. And as you can see, it converts it to gate. It's a very easy way. And now, team 2, object, convert to gate. I don't think you can do this. And if you want to do it with team 1, you go to click on the wall, objects, convert to gate. But of course, they're scrolled up, so it's left out of it. Okay, so team 4. If you guys are wondering how I know this, because blue's always team 1. Red's always team 2, green's always team 3, and bright or baby blue is always team 4. Right, so team 4, you'd obviously change it back to team 4. Click on the wall, objects, convert to gate. Okay, so now you give him a little defense, but you don't want to start him off with everything. Because if you do, it will make it boring and they won't have anything to build. Alright, so you guys could start the game from here, but I mean, you can always make it look better. Like just adding more grass in. There are bushes that you can add in to make it look better. Pretty much just big grass. And as you guys can see, we have a map here. Now, if you wanted to, you could team them up beforehand, but you can always change it, so it's kind of pointless. Or you can make them the same color, but that would get confusing. The AIs are the only ones that I make the same color. It's because they know the difference from each other. But even then, I don't like to do it because it can get confusing to who's who. Especially if they're the same god. Alright guys, I think that this map is good. Next time, I will teach you guys about triggers and the more advanced stuff. And I think that the map is good. I will test play this so you guys can see how the AI performs. It's not gonna perform the best because there's not enough trees to hold off them for very long, but they'll still perform very good. Just later in the game, they'll start being weird because they don't have a lot of trees. And the AI will try to go and steal your goal too if they run out. Okay, let's go to file. Always remember to save it. We'll save it over 1Fishy3000. Turn to main menu. Tortillas. Sounds like they're saying tortillas. You can change your nickname anytime you want. House. I'm gonna change the difficulty before you go here. And go to scenario, 1Fishy, or whatever you named it, of course. And then if you had a friend playing, you leave it open, and then he would join. But he would have to be in the same internet connection as you. So if you wanted to play with a friend over then you would have to go to the online mode. But I'm not going to go into that. Okay, so you set it to standard or any one of these that you want. Attacker, it will do as the name implies. It will just attack faster. Conqueror will do everything pretty much faster. Builder, it'll build. It's pretty much as the name says. Protector, it'll protect allies and itself. Defender will make a good defense. And so I'll just set it all to standard right now. And I'm gonna get destroyed really quick here. Okay. Everything should be good. I have them on random. You can change your gods, change your team, change your mode. They're already greened up to go.
Έτοιμος. Μάλιστα. Έτοιμος. Έστω.
Alright, so they should already be building by now. I'm not going to play this full thing. And obviously, if I did, I would not win. Because I'm playing against three titans. Against by myself.
Βούλομαι. Πάνι. Ορθός. Ορθός.
I don't know why it's so laggy, guys. But I think it's just because I'm recording. That and there's three AIs working at the same time. Alright, let's just go and just... Ah, I should have put these up. Oh well. I'll go and make some small army first. As you see, guys, everything works fine. I think it might have been because I saved over a different file that it's being like this. And, attack piggies.
Prostagma.
Okay.
Etimi. Vulome.
Just to get this over with faster, I'm gonna make Isvoli. My villagers attack. I'll just send them all to attack.
Prosehe. Ne. Isvoli.
And obviously, you can see the AI was working since they're using their scout.
Πρόσταγμα. Εισβολή. Πρόσταγμα.
Πρόσταγμα. Ορθός, ορθός.
Λέγε, ναι. Λέγε, μάλιστα. Έτοιμοι.
Μάλιστα. So as you guys can see, they were about to
Λέγε.
Butt rape me and Έστω. Beat me μάλιστα. Really quickly.
Έτοιμος.
Βούλομαι.
I can't even defeat ορθός. One titan as it is.
Ορθός.
Λέγε, έστω. Εισβολή.
And Έτοιμος. Three titans Λέγε. Would be impossible. For me, at least, not for someone else with more skill. It'd still be hard for anybody. Alright, so... Now that I got the villagers here, please attack! Attack, piggies! Attack, attack! You can attack with pigs all. Okay, so... That's everything, and this is what they've been doing. See how they always collect food first, no matter what? It's just in their programming. I'm not really sure how they got over here, but they did it. So, you can always make the maps bigger, you can make them ginormous. There is a limit though, and you can always make them smaller, which those are always interesting when you make really small maps and have a 4v, or a 1v1v1v1, or whatever. Anyways, guys, you can do multiple different things with this, make interesting maps, and I kind of like this map. I might keep it, just edit a little bit, and show you guys in the future what a fully a full map of mine looks like. Alright guys, this is... I've had fun creating levels with you, but I gotta go. Bye. See you in the next video. Bye.